Jesus say, come unto me and rest. Lay down, O weary one, lay down your head upon my breast. I came to Jesus as I was, so weary one, and said, I found in him a resting place, and he has made me glad.
Beverly Toledo, Theodore Reed, Susan Weaver, David Molnar, Robert Elkins, Sandra DeSarmo, Julia Strudgeon, Robert Katkavage, Ann Weatherford, Carolyn Mackey, Ronald Noblet, Mary Arms, Geraldine Doyle, Patricia Cardinal, Mark Drennan, Diane Pescatello, Fritz Bruning, Evelyn Christie, Ted Zebiak, Sharon Belasco, Nicholas Sheeran, Eugenia Noth, Joseph Dowling, John Reinerson Jr., Sandy Jones Miller, Rita Hudak, Charles Williams, Julia Tehan, Gloria Kehoe, Fred Spooner, Michael Bangank, Arthur Puzicki, Lois Hart, Mary Yancho, Daniel Paris, Trudy Rasmussen, Carol Maxud, Larry Tulio, Francis Daniels, Harold Owens, Lori Anderson, Barbara Lavigne, Diane Bischoff, Wayne Van Ochten, John Mott, Eileen Kirby, Remedios Hakosalam Ponting, Rostico Calau Dagundan, Isidro Eribatan Soon Sr., Jerry Sprague Sr., Deanne Kramer, Robert Cushman, Lee Sorensen, Joey Stevens. At this time, we invite you to pray privately for all of them and those you may have lost and hold dear to your hearts.
And let us pray. Eternal rest grant unto them, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon them, and may they rest in peace, and may their souls and the souls of all the faithful departed, through the mercy of God, rest in peace. Amen. Good morning. As we gather together on this commemoration of all the faithful departed, All Souls Day, let us begin. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And may the Lord be with you. And calling to mind our sins, we call to mind that the Father sent Jesus into the world that we might be freed from sin and eternal death and live with him in our heavenly kingdom. And Lord Jesus, God so loved the world that he sent you to be our Savior and our Redeemer. Lord, have mercy. And Lord Jesus, you sit at the Father's right hand. where you intercede for us. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you have promised that you will prepare a place for us so that where you are, we also may be with you. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us all, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to life everlasting.
Amen.
And let us pray. Listen kindly to our prayers, O Lord, and as our faith in your Son, raised from the dead, is deepened, so may our hope of resurrection for your departed servants also find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, you are one God forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed in the view of the foolish to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. In the time of their visitation, they shall shine and shall dart about as sparks through stubble. They shall judge nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord shall be their king forever. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures he gives me repose. Beside restful waters he leads me. He refreshes my soul.
The Lord is my shepherd.
He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are at my side, with your rod and your staff that give me courage. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured out into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. How much more then, since we are now justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath? Indeed, if while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more, once reconciled, will we be saved by his life? Not only that, but we also boast of God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Yours, O Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. May the Lord write these words on our mind, our lips, our hearts. At that time, Jesus exclaimed, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, you have revealed them to little ones. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves, for my yoke is easy, and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Well, I was a pastor at St. Mary Mount Morris before I retired in June of 2017. You might know that there is a cemetery there at St. Mary's, Calvary Cemetery. Not a great deal of creativity in naming the Catholic cemeteries in our county. One is Old Calvary, and then we have Calvary, then we have New Calvary. So three Calvaries, and it happened not frequently, but sometimes that a funeral procession would drive into Calvary Cemetery and find out they were at the wrong cemetery because they got confused with the name. But one, we had a good youth group there, and as we neared Halloween one year, the youth minister asked if it would be okay if they had a hayride through a Calvary Cemetery. And I said no. I said, first of all, I don't imagine people would like to see a hay wagon driving around the cemetery around their loved ones. But I said, too, it also gives the impression that a cemetery is a scary place, that a cemetery is something we should be afraid of. I said, in reality, it's a garden. You know, not just because there's flowers and plants there, it is a garden of souls. The people who are awaiting the resurrection of the dead. We know from the Gospels that Jesus was buried in a garden, and that he, of course, therefore rose from the dead in a garden. And so the cemetery is a place where our beloved wait until the Lord raises them to new life. Indeed, their souls are with the Lord already, but that glorified body that our Lord Jesus has and that he gifted our Blessed Mother with is what we await at the resurrection of the dead. So those who are awaiting it are not in a scary place, but in a blessed place. As you might know, for the Jewish people of Jesus' time, there were not 10 commandments to follow, but actually 630 commandments. And this is why quite frequently Jesus was asked, as other rabbis, what are the greatest of all the commandments? And he says, these two, you shall love the Lord your God, you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Those 632 laws were referred to as the yoke of the law of Moses, like an oxen wears a yoke to keep them going the right path. No, and Jesus says, my yoke is easy, my burden light, because it's only two commandments, and they're both based on the same thing, love. You shall love the Lord your God, and you shall love your neighbor as yourself. So as we celebrate this day, observe this day in which we give thanks to God for all of our faithful departed, those whom we have loved in this life, let us know that in the communion of saints, you know, relationships are changed, but they're not ended. And so we still relate to our loved ones as they relate to us in the kingdom. And that relationship is basically a communion of love, that will lead to the communion of life eternal. And let us please offer our prayers and our deeds to our beloved Father.
For the Church. May the Holy Spirit guide her in proclaiming the truth of salvation and the love of God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For government leaders, may they be blessed with fortitude in their efforts to protect life from conception to natural death. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick, may the healing presence of God bring them peace and comfort today and always. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of those working on our church renovation, bless the work of their hands and draw them closer to His most sacred heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the prayers that we hold deep in our hearts, and for those written in the parish book of intercessions, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our beloved dead, for those we remember on our banners in the chapel, for those named in our book of remembrance, and for all Holy Family parishioners who died on this date, including Irene Koleski, Helen Petrzak, and Leo Gaston, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the soul of the deceased members of the Holy Family Parish, for whom this Mass is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we know that you will hear and answer all these prayers because we offer them to you in the name of our Lord Jesus. It is He who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit. You are one God forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread that we offer you, the fruit of the earth and the work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. And through the mingling of this water and this wine, may we come to share the divinity of Christ. He has humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine that we offer you, the fruit of the vine, and the work of human hands will become for us our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. And Lord God, accept us and accept the sacrifice we offer to you with humble and contrite hearts. And Lord, wash away my iniquities, cleanse me from all of my sins. Dear sisters and brothers, pray that my sacrifice and yours may be made acceptable to God, our Almighty Father. Amen. Look favorably on our offerings, O Lord, so that your departed servants may be taken up into glory with your Son, in whose great mystery of love we are all united. He who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we might all live forever. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim.
Blessed is he who comes in the
are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Earl, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, our patron saints, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who have trespassed against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, the glory are yours now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace with you, Carrie. Peace with you. Peace with you, Bob. Peace, peace, peace. Peace, peace, peace be with you.
On your stay, greet all his peccas.
Dei, miserere nobis, agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis, agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, dona nobis pacem.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should Jesus,
For all of those praying at home, please join us in your spiritual communion prayer. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that your departed servants, for whom we have celebrated this Paschal sacrament, may pass over to a dwelling place of light and peace through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
With your
and bow your heads for the blessing. May the God of all consolation bless you, for in his unfathomable goodness, he created the human race, and in the resurrection of his only begotten Son, he has given believers the hope of rising again. Amen. To us who are alive, may God grant pardon for our sins, and to all the dead a place of light and peace. Amen. So may we all live happily forever with Christ, whom we believe truly rose from the dead. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down upon you and remain with you forever. Amen. And let us go forth in our Lord's peace. This Mass is ended. Thanks be to God.
St. Michael.
Pray for us.
St. Joseph.
Pray for us.
And all the souls of the faithful departed.
Pray for us.
Sing we for the saints.